tomorrow night on Sky at 6:30 on Sky One.
Do you think it's from the mob?
Abby's in trouble in E Street. At 7 on Sky Sports, it's live Monday night football. Manchester City clash with Queen's Park Rangers. There's terror at 8:15 on the movie channel. Nightmare on the 13th floor. At 10 on Sky Movies Plus, Chuck Norris enforced vengeance. That's tomorrow night on Sky. Coming in September, great entertainment on the movie channel.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
It was a marriage of convenience.
I did it for the green card.
So what happens next?
We can start planning a divorce.
That became an inconvenience.
I'm with the investigations department, the INS, the immigration.
There's been a major clampdown on illegal aliens marrying for residency status.
Some people will do anything for a green card.
Let him move into my apartment. I can't believe you're saying that.
You're going to have to study each other's habits. It's like you're cramming for an exam.
Gerard Depardieu.
Let me do the talking.
Andy McDowell.
How did you two meet?
You go ahead.
No, you please.
Together, for better.
He's gorgeous.
Or worse.
No, and your manners are atrocious.
How do you think that works on your snob?
You're a slob.
This is George. He's a composer.
I really need a screw.
A handyman. He's French.
Devilishly.
A refugee.
He's not a spy or something.
From the director of Dead Poets Society, Green Card.
Please,
a cop killer.
Just make an arrest?
Or killer cop.
Please, don't move!
Got up on the table, said he was homicide.
Stop, I'll shoot!
It was cold to me.
Ice cold.
I've been working that case for 15 months.
Congratulations, case is closed.
Alec Baldwin.
Mind your feet, pal.
What's your name?
Trouble. He's running around playing cop, assaulting and beating people.
Jennifer Jason Leigh.
Hey, man, you still haven't told me what it is you do.
He's a murderer.
Miami Blues.
You ain't no cop.
Oh, I'm a cop.
I came to America in 1914. It was the most beautiful place you've ever seen. And then we came to Avalon.
From the director of Rain Man, a story of three generations of family.
I changed my name.
What are you, a candy bar? You got a name. Kaczynski.
There's a lot of people out there with a lot of money. I think it's a good time to gamble.
Through good times.
My brother's alive in Europe.
Sad times.
Somebody tries to kill my boy just for money.
I burn the store down.
And hard times.
We don't have any insurance to cover this.
They shared a dream called America in a place called Avalon. Joan Plowright, Aidan Quinn, Elizabeth Perkins, and Armin Mueller-Stahl.
We brought you to this country!
You're getting further and further away from Avalon.
Suzanne lived on the edge.
Remember, I'm dropping someone off.
You don't remember taking any drugs?
Sure. Some.
Hi, Mama!
Now she's trying to make a comeback.
For the run of the film, you stayed with your mother.
What am I, a teenager?
Postcards from the Edge.
I did film after film. I never stopped working.
No,
I would
very,
do
very,
that.
Very good therapy for me.
Like mother.
Do you mind if I have a drink?
Like daughter.
Do you mind if I drop acid?
Times and bum times, I've seen them all in my dear.
Ever since I was about 7, I wanted to be you.
I am still here.
I give that sad bellhop.
Are you sure I didn't sleep with you?
Sleep? Yeah.
I was with him Saturday night. That's two girls in one day.
You said you loved me.
I did it at the time.
Never let him see you ache. That's what Mr. Mary used to say. Or was it ass? Never let him see your ass.
Based on Carrie Fisher's best-selling novel.
Relax. They're blank. Teresa, what an unusual name.
I know. I think my parents were expecting someone black.
I don't get your generation's humor.
Oh.
Postcards from the Edge. Films for everyone this September on the Movie Channel. Coming soon to the Movie Channel.
You will be working with patients, people, Doctor.
When you say people, you mean living people? You do want the job, don't you?
Hi.
I'm Dr. Thayer.
I'm Wahida.
Wahida. I'd like to ask.
I was born in 1911 in Kingsbridge, New York. Prior to July 1955, I resided at the Brooklyn Psychiatric Center, Brooklyn, New York.
How are you today?
I'm fine, thank you. Prior to that, I was a person.
It gets easier. You don't think it will, but it does.
Can you hear me? Does he ever speak to you?
Of course not. Not in words.
No change, date 9/11/44.
Your patients, Doctor, haven't moved in decades.
What I believe, what I know, is these people are alive inside.
How do you know that, Doctor?
I know it.
I just wanted to say to you, I preferred your explanation.
At 200 milligrams, he showed no response. Maybe he needs more.
Maybe he needs less.
It's there. It's a miracle.
Where are my glasses?
They're on your face.
I don't think that I could deal with losing 30 years of my life, could you?
Have you thought what you'd like to do today?
Everything.
Leonard, where are you going?
I would do all the things that you people take for granted. I'd go for a walk. I'd look at things. I'd talk to people.
You work here?
No, I live here.
You don't look like a patient.
I don't?
Girls!
You're not married. Me?
Would you like to go out for a cup of coffee?
Coming in October to the Movie Channel.
My name is Peter Fallow, the man of the moment, the toast of the town. But it wasn't always this way. Let me tell you how it all began. In the 80s, making money and living well was all that mattered. And no one did it better than Sherman McCoy. Now he was a master of the universe.
Calm, cool, collated. Let's not lose our composure over a few $100 million.
No one could resist him. Not his mistress.
This could be the best sex I've had in a long time.
Not even his dog.
It's raining and he's not happy about it, Mr. McCoy.
Here am I, Bill.
I, on the other hand, was a reporter in need of a story.
This is Peter Fallow, the has-been.
Oh, Shantae.
In need of a spark. Which is exactly what I got.
It looks like...
It's an animal.
No, I think it's a tire.
It's a dead tire?
I turned that spark into a flame.
Hello, Peter. I think there's a hell of a story.
We're investigating an automobile accident.
Yeah, on television. Last night, we have a Mercedes.
Mr. McCoy, is there something you want to tell us?
When the flame spread.
Did you say Henry Lamb was an honor student?
Good doesn't really apply at Rupert High. They're either cooperative or life-threatening.
Nothing is going to come of that little newspaper article.
I got him!
There he is, Ms. McCoy!
Absolutely
not him. I'm going to jail.
And suddenly, I was the guy who had everything. Hey, opportunity knocks. Someone's got to answer the door.
I want to see the truth come out and burn every one of them, and there's only one way to do that.
What's that?
Lie.
October on Sky Movies Plus.